Quintus Horatius Flaccus, better known as Horace, was born on the 8th of December in the year 65 BC. He was raised in a lovely little town named Masuria in the Samnites. Horace's father was once a slave. Later freed, he worked hard to provide a good life and, more importantly, a good education for his son. Thus, Horace was sent to the capital of culture and of aesthetics, Athens, to become a learned man. Upon the completion of Horace's education, the first Roman social war forced its way into Horace's life. Being the strapping young lad that he was, hot-headed and ready for the centrifuge of war, which separated the men from the boys, Horace joined up, fighting at Philippi. But as it turned out, war wasn't as happening and as hip as Horace anticipated. In fact, Horace was sickened by the brutality and wanton violence that he would later denounce in his writings. Horace's funds and properties were confiscated in the aftermath of the social war. Desperate and needy, like any good artist, Horace remembered his education and began to write. As it so happened, the good Lady Luck struck Horace with her scepter of fortitude, and his writings became an immediate success. The Odes were unlike any other poem before, in that Horace pioneered a novel metrical form that allowed for the better expression of his ideas. Horace explored the heavy topics of corruption, war, civil disorder, and the general moral destitute of the Roman people in his writings, earning him both the controversy in the streets and at the dinner tables. The public ate his works up, one after another. Indeed, Octavian's own supporters began to notice this rising star. At the apex of his career, Horace was nominated to the Circle Around Maecenas, a prestigious literary club whose membership included another famous poet, Virgil. Using his newfound wealth and fortune, Horace toured Rome and her provinces, visiting upon all walks of life to expand upon his subject matter. He undertook many bold adventures, including a naval expedition and a near-drowning incident at Brisunium. Horace even witnessed firsthand the notorious Battle of Actium, which he wrote about in the Odes. However, as Horace gradually became more and more accustomed to his plush and luxurious life in the upper circles of Rome, his habit of criticizing the status quo became increasingly contradictory to his actual writings. Many of his later poems, especially those concerning the Odes, paid a certain mandatory respect to Augustus and his policies. Today, Horace's works are still highlighted as some of the greatest classical literature ever composed. The highest classes appreciated Horace the most. Poets such as Robert Frost and James Thompson especially valued Horace's insights into the politics of love, friendship, war, and of course, politics itself. Undoubtedly, Horace's most prominent point of influence was during the Age of Enlightenment, where Augustan culture was at its eminence. European authors even bestowed the title of Horace to any writer of distinguished ability and profound insight. This action led to the creation of many different nationalities of Horace across Europe. While the direct effect of Horace on works past the 21st century are somewhat unclear, there is no doubt that Horace's enigmatic writings will be here to stay.
I just keep changing my mind.
The whole point of the process, you know?
Horace. It's too loud. It's too loud. Quintus Horatius Flaccus, better known as Horace, was born on the 8th of December in the year 65 BC. He was raised in a lovely little town named Visunia in the Samnites. Horace's father was once a slave. Later freed, he worked his way into a good life, providing... Shit. Quintus Horatius Flaccus, better known as Horace, was born on the 8th of December in the year 65 BC. He was raised in a lovely little town named Masuvia in the Samnites. Horace's father was once a slave. However, he was later freed and worked hard to provide a good life and, more importantly, a good education for his son. Thus, Horace was sent to the culture... Why?
Why? Why?